We are live. There we go. Alright, I do think that we are live. Hello everyone, and welcome to PHOF6, where it's going to be a dry qualifying session and a dry race here in Singapore. We have almost full field of 16 drivers, sorry, I'm just counting myself, and can't wait to see the action unfold. We have a Force India and Keloniex out first. I wonder who that Force India is. If I could switch to them, that'll be nice. Oh, we have Onto the Podium coming out as well. We have AJ, it's Tyler Neo who leads everyone. No, it's Ash Best who was out very quick. Zebra's also out, Nas is out. Loads and loads of cars out, all in the first sector. They're going to have to spread out. Let's go on board with Onto the Podium for this entire lap. This is going to be very interesting to see. In the Renault of Kevin Magnussen today is Onto the Podium. Hoping not to get taken out is what he told me. 10 cars out on track already, and we are only 2 minutes in to the session. Onto the Podium has a little bit of traffic in front of him. He's going to have to let off the throttle if he wants some space at all. So yeah, this is going to be a very exciting race. I can feel it. We have the likes of Mr. Stim, the Zebra 94, Lars Gaming, 123, Onto the Podium, who are all going to try and get the win here. Under the lights. And as the season is drawing to its latter stages, the championship battle is really hotting up. All the way up and down in the field. I've been drafted in to do this race tonight. Really wanted to race, so I'm effectively losing out on a race. And Onto the Podium, right on the back of a Red Bull. That is not what he's going to want on his actual lap. I mean, I have no idea what he's doing, but this is absolutely terrible. This is going to mess up his lap if the Red Bull in front messes up. I think that's the Zebra 94 in front of him. I mean, Zebra is a very fast driver, but if he does make a mistake, he's going to have to get right out of the way of Onto the Podium. And Onto the Podium is absolutely hounding him. Is that actually the Zebra? It is indeed. Oh, and Kellon's actually having to make an overtake on his lap. That is terrible traffic. But look at that Zebra weaving left and right to try and lose. To try and make Onto the Podium lose a slipstream, and he actually goes purple, which is very good of him. He goes purple by 0.4. Someone sets someone's 1 second. Tyler Neo 1 second off of the onto the podium space. Pretty sure the Zebra has gotten out of Onto the Podium's way. Yep, he's parked it up. So very clean lap so far, what I've seen from Onto the Podium, very close to the bridge there, nice and clean through the hairpin. This is looking very, very good indeed. Coming into the third sector now, I do believe it. That might have been a cut. He goes purple yet again. Let's compare this to Mr. Stim. Where is he? Mr. Stim, definitely one of the closest competitors. Oh, it is slightly not even close. If I can say that, he goes under the grandstand now. The lights shining off of that Renault. That fluorescent yellow Renault. That rhymes. Coming up to the final two corners now. It's very clean, but it's also slightly conservative. It's a 42.4 from Onto the Podium, and that puts him on provisional pole by 0.9 from Ash Best, who's actually on the Super Soft, so that is not too shabby at all from Ash Best. He will not be disappointed with that at all. And I think Onto the Podium's going on another lap, but we've already given him some coverage. Have no idea who to follow now. Let's go on board with AJ. Currently 0.6 off of onto the podium. On the super soft, so that is very good. That is very good. Onto the podium, looking. Oh, I think someone has gone faster. No. Yep, Deo's gone far. Weebalf's gone faster. No idea how to say his name, so I'm just going to say Flaviu, because Flaviu's his name, only that's spelled backwards. Pretty sure onto the podium is not on the lap anymore. Yep, he is. He is retired from that lap. Let's go back on board with AJ, who sets a 40. Wait, if I can find him. 40.1 in the second sector. So he's 2 seconds off of the pace. That is not good for him at all. That is not what he's going to want. Not 2 seconds, sorry. 1 second and a bit. So that's definitely not what Toro Rosso want. And apparently we are going to be expecting light rain in about 10 minutes, says Jeff. No idea why he's actually in my ear. No idea why he's in my ear. That was very strange. Where's AJ? He's P7. I don't think he improved that lap either. And onto the podium, peels into the pits after saying that pole lap time. No one really to cover at the moment. Although there are 12 cars on track. Let's go on board with Mr. Stim now. One of the main competitors for the championship in F6. He's actually leading the championship at the moment. What's his first sector going to be like? It's a 28.9 and he's blown onto the podium right out of the water with that, going a tenth faster than him. That is very, very good indeed. And oh, I wanted to check the race director, but I'm not going to leave this screen. It's a little bit shaky through that left-hander. He definitely did not get the exit that he wanted through the old Singapore sling. Now and into this new section. I don't really like that they brung it out slightly. Oh, and he hits the wall through there. That's definitely going to compromise his lap time. I'm into the hairpin now. Bit of a more shallow line through there. So he wants the entrance speed, not the exit speed. It's a 39.4 in the middle sector. That is decent. That is decent. Oh, but it's not quite onto the podium pace. We're going to have to see this last set. Oh, that was definitely a cut. That is definitely invalidated his lap time. Although Stim keeps going, so we're going to have to see. Under the grandstands now in that lovely manner. And under the bridge now in a moment. Yep, he goes under the bridge. Into the final two corners, very attacking in comparison to onto the podium. He takes a very shallow line through there, and he, oh no, sorry, I thought I went on pole. That was very embarrassing. It was indeed invalidated, and he's only 0.2 off of onto the podium's time. That is very unfortunate. Oh, onto the podium going out. Gonna stay on board with Mr. Stim though. No, we're not. Onto the podium going out on another set of ultrasofts. Very interesting that. So Mr. Sim with a 28.9 in the middle, in the first sector even, sorry. That's very, very good, although not quite purple, because he did set a faster first sector earlier. If Mr. Stim was to go onto the ultrasofts, he would blow the competition right out of the water, I tell you that much. Although there is a Force India going slowly in front of him, so that might compromise his time. Will he go wide at the hairpin? He doesn't. Who is that? It's Tyler Neo. We saw him holding up a Mercedes earlier on in this session. Oh, and he doesn't even move over Mr. Stim. He will definitely not be happy with that. Tyler Neo showing no respect for Stim whilst Stim was on his flying lap. Although, I do think that Tyler Neo is also on a flying lap, so maybe he had no option. Although, saying that, Mr. Stim has gone faster than onto the pit. Oh no, he peels into the pits. It was definitely invalidated. So let's go on board with onto the podium now. He's coming around the final corner. There goes Mr. Stim, and he starts his lap time now. Let's go onto the broadcast cameras. We've spent way too much time on the onboard cameras even, sorry. It's nice and clean through the first two corners. Those are actually the first three corners. I'll actually get a track map up after this lap. Anyway, he's in the DRS zone now, coming into the heavy braking zone of turn number 6. I think this is at a 29.0. It's not quite purple. He is 2 tenths. Not even 2 tenths, sorry. I'm going to sneeze. Oh, pardon me. It is 2 hundredths. Oh, 2 hundredths off of his purple lap time. Oh, Stim expressing his anger over the corner cutting. Also saw Tyler Neo go onto the Ultrasofts and Defo getting pole. He is very, very confident about his chances at pole, and you can't blame him. He's only 2 tenths off a vote onto the podium on the slower tire, though. Onto the podium he has gone purple in the middle sector, and I think that this is just above his delta. Coming through the final few, through the final complex now, and into the final. Oh no! He comes into the pits. That's quite strange. Right, cool. Let's go on board with LFC 4Life 7-11 now, or 7-1-1. He's going very slowly, presumably trying to get some space to the cars around him. Although I don't really see any cars really near him. That's slightly strange. Right. FC with a very conservative approach through the final two corners. And down the straight he goes into turn number 1. Very, very attacking through there. Through turn number 3 now. And there's the Toro Rosso going slowly. He lets him through. That is very kind of him. Through turn number 5, I think this is now. I really need to get that track map up. I really do. He's taking a shallow line through there. That will definitely not help his speed through there. It's a 29.3. Thank you very much, Jeff. Don't know if you heard that, but there'll be rain in the next few moments. So LFC might be slightly screwed over here. We're going to have to see. Trying to find him. Yes, that is a 2 tenths improvement on his first sector. Very good on him. Let's try. Oh my god, massive lag from LFC as he comes into the hairpin. It looks, oh, he goes slightly wide, but other than that it looks very, very good. Coming into the sector 3 split now, or sector 2 split. It's a 40.0. It is 2 tenths slower. And his fastest middle sector, and it is, oh, as Mr. Sim retires, we need to have a look. Oh, and he's binned it out of the final corner. That is unfortunate for him. So there will be no chance at pole for the Latvian in the Marussia Manor even. And that's definitely an invalidated lap by LFC. Yep, he peels into the pits. Now, who's that Toro Rosso behind him? It's AJ. Very fast driver. Let's see where he'll be able to place his Toro Rosso through turn 1, 2 and 3. Not quite as attacking as you'd maybe expect. Oh, very nice camera. Oh, never mind. Not quite as attacking as you would expect through there on a quali lap. Let me get up my Singapore street circuit map. How's the first sector look? It's a 29.9. Pretty sure that is a slight improvement. Nope, he's gone slow by a tenth. The Singapore track map. Pardon me, sorry. I just need to get this up to get the corners right. Oh, that is a very nice track map, but if it's PNG then I might not see it. It is PNG indeed, and I can't see it. I'm looking for the track map. Oh no, this is not good at all. He sets a 39.7 in the middle sector. That is almost a second off of pole. Sorry, I'm still looking for my track map. Wait. There was one with corner name. Not even corner names. Corner numbers. Yep, I've got it. What lap time was that? 1:45.3 seconds off of. 2.5 seconds off of pole. Tyler Neo, probably out of fuel. Ask Carwold, what's the likelihood of Stim coming back from last place to win? Onto the podium also, kicking Stim while he's down. This is not very nice, lads. This is not nice at all. It's Ashbest. Ashbest in P4. Good on him. Good on him. Almost a second off of pole by onto the podium. What's the likelihood of Stim coming back from last place to win? Well, it didn't work out in Italy and round Singapore, a track that is notorious for the lack of overtaking opportunities. I don't think that is going to be that Stim's going to be that fortunate. Oh, as the two Force Indias are brawling out on track. Tony's has got a puncture. Might have been a little bit of contact between the two Force Indias, and you never know. As the rain is coming down here. The rain definitely is coming down. I can't quite see it. But the rain is. Yep, the rain is coming down here. At Yas Marina. Yep, Punjabi Panthers. Thank you very much. Punjabi Panthers. But we have 40 seconds remaining in the session, and I think that the standings are pretty much set now that the rain has come down. So let's run. Right, heavy rainfall out on track in 10 minutes. Now I know what's happened here, because F1 2016 has been playing up recently. It has been. It's been corrupting left, right and centre recently. Alright. Anyway. Our lineup here for F6 Singapore is onto the podium. Deo, Lars Gaming, Ashbest, Kellyon X, Levi, Flavio, Bozo Giu, LFC for life managing to break the top 10. Zebra in 10th, AJ 11th, Tyler Neo 12th, Soyborg 13th, Elenoget 14th, 15th Timme, and Stim lines up last. Let's quickly leave and try and get reinvited. Hopefully. Not reinvited, rejoin. That's what I meant. Right. Just having a look through my track map, making sure I've got everything down, so I won't have to look at it that much. 23 corners round the Singapore city street circuit. Quite remarkable. That's an amazing amount of corners if you compare that to a track like Austria, which only has 9 corners. That is quite astounding. Anyway, they go for their formation lap onto the podium in the Renault, leads them away. This is going to be a very exciting race, in my opinion. lots of opportunities, not for overtakes, but just for... Okay. Pretty sure Tyler Neo and Zebra came together there. Very, very interesting. Anyway, let me have a little bit of a sneeze. Or blow my nose, rather, shall I say. So, let's run you through the field yet again. It's onto the podium. It's onto the podium on pole. It's Deo in P2, Lars in P3, Ashbess is 4th, Kelonyeks 5th, the South African in the Mercedes, Levi on the grid in P6, Flavio is 7th in the Red Bull, Bozo is P8, very split qualifying for the Renaults, P1 and P8. LFC for Life is 9th. Zebra's 10th on the grid. AJ is P10. Tyler's P12 on the grid. The 13th is Soyborg. 14th is Ella Noget. 16th is Mr. Stim. And 17th is Timme. So, there is the grid for you for this F6 race around Singapore. This might be a good one. I have that feeling. This might be a very good race. Anyway, they come round in the final few corners and onto the podium peels into his grid slot. It's not a very long run into turn one here at Singapore, so he's gonna have to do the utmost he can to keep that first position. Anyway, this is not the broadcast cam that I want. Let's go on board with Deo. Lights build up, it's 5 red lights and it is lights out and away we go for the F6 Singapore Grand Prix. Deo's nowhere near onto the podium. I do apologise. Lars Gaming tries to make a move around the outside. It's very, very orderly through turn one. I was not expecting that. Wow, very, very clean through there. Oh, but there is like there are it's 4 wide. Oh no, UV Alf getting it all wrong and punting Zebra, who in turn punted AJ. I think that is very unfortunate for the Red Bull and Toro Rosso. Onto the podium leads, and to be honest, he is my personal favorite, you know, good friend. So hope he can take the win here. Hopefully he won't bottle it completely. Ash Best has moved himself past Lars Gaming, and he's into P3. Lovely shot of the cars coming through the old Singapore sling. Oh, there is some battling going on between Bozo Giyu and LFC for Life for P7. But LFC, oh, there's a safety car deployed for reasons unbeknownst to me. I have no idea why the safety car has just come out, but this will definitely screw over people on the ultra soft tyre, on the super soft tyre. Ashbest being one of them. He is the highest running super soft tyre. He's the highest running car on the super softs. Next is Levi, just 3 cars behind. So that has calmed it down somewhat on the first lap. Not as hectic as I thought that it would be, but still a little element of what I don't even know. Is Ashbest peeling into the pits there? He is, and he actually cut the white line whilst entering into the pits. You can't get anything on this game for doing that, but in real life he would be mincemeat with the stewards. How does that happen? How did Bozo Giyu get disqualified? The only way you could do that on this game is by corner cutting. I'm not quite sure that he racked up enough blocking the pit lane. Classic error. Caught me out once or twice in my career, so yeah, you have to really feel for him, in my opinion. Anyway, the guys are forming up here. Oh, Bozogu, definitely not happy with that, with an OMG in the F6 chat. Stim did well, says Stim about himself. Huh. Anyway, let's go through the new order of this Grand Prix. It's onto the podium, who still leads. Deo, who is still in P2. Lars Gaming, who is still in P3. Kellon, who's moved up into P4. Levi, who's moved up into P5. Tyler, who has had a pretty good start to get into P6, I think. Not sure where he started, actually. Oh, it doesn't actually tell me, unfortunately. Oh, well. It's Mr. Stim 7th, who's had an absolutely amazing start from P16, so a win might still be on the cards for the Latvian in the manor. Eleno Get is P8. And his teammate is right behind in P9. The Zebra, after that, coming together with his teammate, is P10. AJ is P11. Ash, after making his pit stop, and he's gone to the soft, so he's definitely looking to go very, very far in this race. LFC, who had a very good qualifying session, but unfortunately he's down into P13 now. Don't know how that's happened. Timmit is in P14, and Weevalf, or Flavio, rounds out the field. Oh dear. Safety car, I don't even know why it came out. No idea. Oh, I need to stretch. I need to itch. There's a little bit of commotion going on behind these leaders, look like. Lots of ghosting all over the place. Well, let's have a run through the race director. So Tyler Neo and LNO get warnings. Bozo with a completely shock disqualification from this race. Next it is Levi, who Levi gets a warning for a collision with Kellon. And, that is unfortunate. LFC for life, getting a drive through for falling too far back. Those can really be annoying. Especially around street circuits when you can't corner cut your way back to the car ahead. And Kellon has a stop go for ignoring yellow flags. So, it might not have been hectic on track, but it's definitely been hectic in the stewards. With a fair few penalties, even a disqualification being handed out on the first few laps. And now we just wait for the safety car to come in. Probably going to do one more lap. If I was onto the podium, I'd have pitted, if I'm honest. Although track position on around Singapore is vital. But if I was him, I would have pitted for some more durable tyres. Although the Ultrasofts can go quite a few laps, I think he had to maybe pit onto the Supersofts. That might have worked out for him. That might have worked out. I'm not sure. Oh, I think there's a Mercedes peeling into the pits. No, Kellon trying to trick a few opponents, I think that was. A shot of the cars going through the final corner. And the guy's weaving. So do they know that that actually will affect their tyre wear? So, a little tip for... Oh, Timmy's into the pits, so is Flavio. Another set of softs. Don't really see why I had to do that. Wait, let me just recheck the race director. Oh, that is unfortunate. Timmy and Weevalf came together under the safety car, no less. That is not good at all. That is not good. Wolkoff going slowly. I think he is an AI car. Might be checking in on the street. No, never mind. Onto the podium, getting a little bit impatient with the safety car, it looks like, trying to overtake Bert Mailander. Oh, it looks like the safety car is coming in. Sorry, I was just checking my stream. Right, so safety car restart onto the podium. Is going to try and bolt as soon as he can from Deo behind him. I think he's done it now, and that's not the best place you want to bolt. But I think the safety car is just there. He's not going to have a chance to bolt. He's definitely not going to have a chance to bolt. That severely hurt him, and that might actually help out people further back, as they will have amazing runs. Oh, Lars Gaming going up the inside of Deo into turn one. Oh, Deo has to go off track, and he's definitely going to have to give that position back as Kellon, opportunistic. Yet Deo does give the position back, and now Lars is free to chase onto the podium, but I think onto the podium will just walk away with this one. He's been very confident all week, and I think that Lars has little a chance as Tyler Neo making a move on a Stim, I think that was. So he promotes himself into P number... No. I think he was defending from Stim. Stim was P7. Zebra going wider, he might have some damage, or maybe he might just have some lag. Ash Best, who qualified P4 and was P3 by the first lap, is now in P11 trying to get past Soyberg, and that's actually AJ, who's maybe going to try and make a move into the hairpin. He has done so, and unfortunately Ash Best has gone round. Not sure why that is. The angle was slightly unfortunate on the broadcast camera, and the field is slightly spread out, except from this gaggle, from 3rd to 7th, maybe even 2nd to 7th. This might be interesting to watch. Kellon in P5. Things have definitely calmed. Oh, and onto the podium is storming away with this race at the moment. Flavio's going to have to serve that drive-through. Was it a drive-through? Pretty sure it was. Oh, and Ash Best concedes that position to Flavio, and he puts himself into last position. Very unfortunate considering where he qualified. That is very, very unfortunate. He'll definitely not be happy with that one. Although, there's a chance a little bit of a battle, but I will check further up the grid. Oh, yep. Mr. Sim trying to make the move on Tyler Neo, goes right up his inside at turn number 7, having to glance at the track map, and he makes it stick. Very easy move for P6. And oh, look at the gap that onto the podium is established already. He's absolutely walking away with this at the moment. It is unbelievable scenes. Although it is kind of believable, considering the amount of confidence he had all the way through this week. Oh, there's a Tyler Neo, I think, clipping the hairpin and almost going spinning. Like this helicopter cam. Flavio's in P13 with a puncture. That is unfortunate. no idea where that's come from. Maybe from Timmy, because he hasn't got an end plate on the left side of his front wing, and Ash is still last, so that is unfortunate for the guys at the back. And oh, on to the podium. It's walking away with this one. It's unbelievable. What is the gap? Oh, 4 seconds already. It is unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. Well, it is unbelievable. No, yeah, no, I'm not going to make that joke again. Let's go on board with Kellon for the time being, as I try to find my phone, which I have dropped foolishly. Oh, no. Oh, I found it. Sorry. So, let's look at... Oh, onto the podium. Oh, no. Oh, we have to get into the party. I missed that. Oh, he's bottled it. Oh, my goodness me. Oh, my goodness. Onto the podium. Has well and truly bottled it. If I am correct, he has retired from the race. He has. It is terminal damage. And I don't even know what happened. My phone dropped just at that time. What a bottle. 4 seconds out in the lead. Oh, and we have a lovely battle here between Deo and Levi. And Levi absolutely mugs Deo off there, I have to admit. And now here's onto the podium, who bottled it whilst being 4 or 5 seconds in the lead. That is unfortunate, mate. Really, really sympathise with you. What happened there, mate? What happened there? What happened there, mate?
Really, I want to kill myself. I want to kill myself.
Well, that is... can't... Everyone was behind you, mate. What happened there? Wow. Oh, and that's the sound of his controller going into Narnia. Anyway, let's focus on this battle over P3, I think it is. Actually, no, let's have a look down the rest of the field. Actually, there was a gaggle of cars up ahead. No, that's my Sauber parked up at turn one. Oh, Ella gets very close to running into the back of AJ. And Soyborg is right by. Oh, looks like both Haas have understeer problems. Ashbeth is running P11 after pitting for the softs very early on. Timmy's at 13th, and Flavio is having a race to forget in P14, over a minute off of Lars Gaming, the leader. Well, onto the podium, shall I refer to you as Connor more sympathetically? What happened there, mate? No, I missed it because my phone dropped on the floor, you know. What happened there?
Honestly, I glitched inside the wall and it just ruined my car.
Well, that is...
I'm gonna look back at the recording. I need to see what happened.
That's an unfortunate one, mate. At least I wasn't on board with you, because now my audio would be absolutely terrible. And it looks like no one is within half a second of each other at the moment. A very, very boring race now that Onto the Podium has completely and utterly bottled it from the lead of the race, although Levi... sorry, but we can't really accept that kind of language on this family-friendly stream, the PSGL stream. Yep, Levi's closing up.
Stop mocking me.
Oh, both top two cars running number 10. Look, Nars Gaming, number 10. And no, not Kenon. Levi, number 10. So it's a 10-1-2 for number 10, I guess. Don't know where I was going with that one. And Stim's looking to party. Stim is definitely going to pick up where Onto the Podium left off. That is very unfortunate for the Renault driver. Losing more points at the top of the table to Mr. Stim. And he did say before the race that he's going to try and absolutely nab the points off of Stim, but it looks like it's going to be Stim that's going to be doing the nabbing, unfortunately, for him. Any thoughts on that? Onto the podium?
It's mine to lose.
And you did indeed lose it. That is unfortunate. That is very unfortunate.
I'm watching back what happened to me now.
Alright. Honestly, no one's within. Oh! Deo and Ashbest. Deo has pitted for the soft tyres. And Ashbest is just ahead. He's closing in the Lithuanian at a rate of knots coming into the hairpin. Ashbest even goes defensive into the hairpin. Deo's definitely going to have the slipstream, but will he have the cojones to make a move into this corner? Nope, he doesn't quite have the... I'm not even going to say anything. Anyway, oh no, he tries to make a dive into a corner that will definitely end in tears if you go side by side in. That almost ended in tears actually, and I don't know why I keep on repeating this. I can't let it all out. Oh, Levi's in the lead of the race, so Lars Gaming presumably Lars Gaming has pitted from the lead of the race. Mr. Stim is now promoted into P2, so onto the podium, losing bucket loads of points to his main championship rival.
They're side by side, they come through turn 2 as contact, and it looks like Dave's forced Ash into the wall.
And that's actually turn 3, I have the track map up. Into turn 5 they go.
And any damage.
Nope, the manor is running a plank of a front wing anyway, so won't really make a difference, will it? Into turn number 7 they both go, and yep, I think this battle is well and truly over. If you can keep an eye on that, please, Bottler, that'll be fine, thanks. Meanwhile, at the top of the table, Levi and Stim are toe-to-toe here. This is going to be very exciting to watch. And when I said that this race is slightly boring under the safety car, I take that right back. As Stim looking to make a move into the grandstand section, he pulls out of it very smartly. That would have ended in more tears than you can count, if I'm honest. Coming into the final complex, it looks like Levi might pit in. No, he doesn't. Oh, that's a cut from Levi. Stim getting disgusting traction through there, and he definitely won't be able to make the move into turn 1. Well, let's go on board with him now through turn number 2 and 3, following that Williams car of Levi 11. Into turn number 5 they go now. On Sims definitely got a better run than the Williams driver ahead of him. He might make the move into turn number 7. He'll definitely make the move into turn number 7. He pulls alongside Levi and he goes up his inside. That is Mr. Sim promoted into the lead of the race. And if there's anyone losing out on this, it's definitely onto the podium in my opinion. P3 Kellon is actually 10 seconds off of the leader, so very spaced out field at the moment.
Just looking at the penalties, and Mr. Stim has a 3-second penalty for multiple warnings. Though I'm not sure if that's contact or corner cutting.
Definitely corner cutting.
Tyler Neo has a 3-second.
Kellon X, yep. Levi. Flavio, Deo. Deo again? No, sorry. Yeah, Deo has. Deo got one outright. Like, he just got 3 seconds straight up. What a corner that must have been.
Well, I've just been on board of Ash, and he's cut 2 corners within a lap, so one more and he'll get a 3-second penalty.
Oh, actually, check
like
his...
He's falling behind the Mercedes car, and it looks like he's struggling on the soft tyre.
Oh, but there's... Oh, Deo and Soyberg battling, I think, and... One of them was very close to the wall. No, that's just his pace actually. I watched him earlier. No, that wasn't rude. I'm just saying.
Going into this race, I'm sure Ash was trying to make a one-stop work, but hitting into the safety car, that's definitely a two-stop as soon as it comes into the pit.
We are on board with the Zebra now, chasing down LFC4Life, who was also one of my favourites for this race, or ones to watch for this race. Coming onto the main straight, Zebra has the DRS on the Force India. Will he go defensive into turn one? Oh, the Zebra trying to make a move from very far back, and he's actually tagged the back of the Force India, who actually moved in the braking zone. That is definitely footage that you can use in the stewards if you want to. Well, I'm not implying that you have to, I'm just saying that if you want to, it's right there. A very, very brash defensive move from LFC, as we're on board with the Ferrari of Lars Gaming now, right behind the Toro Rosso of AJ. And I'm actually gonna...
Oh, it's still hit the wall, but I don't think there's any damage. There might be. There was a little bit of contact with the wall.
I'm quickly gonna take off the comments to make the broadcast that little bit prettier. There we go. Nice and full screen now. I can just watch the comments on my tablet. And Lars actually gets past AJ. Once again, getting distracted by my tablet, unfortunately. Sorry, everybody, for that. Lars Gaming moves up into P4. How long is the pit lane round here in Singapore? Do you know?
It's quite a slow pit lane due to the exit and the entrance, so I'd say like 25 seconds maybe, at a guess.
So Lars is in the effective race lead, because he's only 22 seconds off of Mr. Stim, who leads this race on lap 13.
It will be close.
It just depends if Stim... Oh, as Kellon is into the pits and he's put on a set of the soft tyres. LFC and Zebra. Zebra managing to close that gap to LFC down to a second, even after getting spun round by the Force India at turn number one. Zebra going all over the curve at turn number three. That will definitely not help him out in terms of traction and stewards or race director or warnings. LFC for life goes defensive to the outside. Yeah, he has realised his mistake and trying to move over onto the inside. Oh, Zebra tried to pressure him into going very wide there, but doesn't quite work. As they file through turn 8 and turn 9, Zebra's going to make a dive bomb his inside at turn number 9. Oh,
he's really struggling on this soft tyre, isn't he?
Yeah, and it doesn't really help that Zebra is on very new, or at least I think that they are very new, ultra soft tyres. Through 11 and 12 they go into the hairpin at turn number 13. LFC for life goes slightly defensive. Zebra in a Force India sandwich. I'm quickly going to check up on Stim to see if he's pitted at all. Nope, he's actually started a new lap. Wow. Anyway, back to this battle between the Force Indias and the Red Bull of Zebra. Zebra looking every way he can. Oh no, that is a bit of front wing lost on the Red Bull, and that is definitely not what he wants around a very high downforce track. If this was around Italy, yep, it would still hurt, especially at corners like Parabolica and Ascari, but it wouldn't be that hurtful, especially if you're running very high wings like I actually once did in a practice session.
As he goes into the pit, he's had enough, he gets out of that train.
Yep, probably the best, because, you know, he did lose that front half his front wing, actually. Let's see what tyres he's going to put on. What are they? He's going onto the soft tyres, so maybe trying to go to the end. He might actually make that work. Anyway.
He might be able to do that, but tyre weight is not strong on this track.
Indeed. The two Force Indias are very close to each other now, and LFC for life once again defending to the inside, and now the outside is waving all over the place. Is the, I don't know, Scouser? Is he actually from Liverpool?
I think so, yeah.
Still kind of offensive to call him a Scouser. Oh, no, that is definitely team orders between the Force Indias. Not that there's anything wrong with team orders, except that if it's Austria 2002. If anyone knows that race. Have you seen Austria 2002?
I have.
Oh, for the Ferraris switched position. Schumacher overtook Barrichello on the line. Barrichello let him past. On the line.
Great fact.
on the line. That's the fact that you can use your Barrichello career mode. Let me check back up on this. Yep, Kellon definitely catching these guys. And LFC might actually be a kind of Massa character to Kellon, trying to.
Lost it.
The Red Bull of who?
Oh.
If Flavio has got another puncture, that is unfortunate. I did see him have a puncture. Yep, he did. That is very unfortunate for him.
I'm not sure how that happened. I think he may have just oversteered. He caught the end of that.
Zebra looking like the Stig. Pardon? Oh. Oh, bottle. Alright then.
Video will be out on my channel.
Not quite sure how the shoes can do anything about that, but I guess we'll have to see.
I will be played in against the race designer of this track.
Against the tyre barrier number 954. Probably aren't 900 tyre barriers around here. There's definitely 900 concrete barriers.
Him looking like he's struggling on the tyre, drifting it through the final corner, but he stays out.
We are midway through the race, so I'm going to do an onboard lap with Mr. Stim. A little bit late though, as we catch him through turn number 4. Into turn number 5 he goes now. Very conservative on both throttle and braking. He is short shifting quite a lot, so definitely trying to save the tyres, trying to make them go the distance. Into turn number 7 he goes, and although he is conserving those tyres, he is going very quickly indeed, pulling the gap to Levi, I think, still. All very sideways through turn number 9. Into the old Singapore sling he comes, turn number 10, followed in quick succession by turn number 11 and turn number 12 into the hairpin of 13. Nice. Oh, very close. Lucky not to hit the barrier on the inside. That would have lost his lead. He might even have lost a tyre.
Shut up.
Sorry. Couldn't resist.
Shut up.
Sorry. Anyway, into turn number 17 he goes, about to go under the grandstands in a moment. At turn number 18, there he goes. Very, very nice, very smooth from the Latvian into 20 and 21. And the final two corners, turn number 22 and 23, he stays out for one more lap, and that is a lap with your leader, Mr. Stim, 96. As Lars Gaming is definitely closing the gap at the top of the table, he is only 17 seconds off of Stim, so he probably will emerge in front of the Manor.
He's come aboard of KillerNex. He is chasing down LFC for life. It looks like he's actually struggling to get past him. He's very late on the brakes, but he just can't get past Force India.
Yep, as I said earlier, maybe LFC for life proving to be a Massa-type character, helping his teammate get away whilst he holds up the opposition.
Seems to be catching. I think that's a Red Bull ahead of him. Might be.
No, it is Tyler Neo. Oh, no, that is a lapped Red Bull of Flavio, I am pretty sure, because Flavio has not had the rub of the green. Yep, that is Flavio. He's not been lucky at all this race. As Kellon oh my god, there's lag everywhere. 1 second he was pulled off at the final corner, the next he's absolutely speeding down the. Oh my goodness!
Oh, he's in the wall. Okay, no flag.
Yep, this is what I'm talking about. I mean, it doesn't help that he's halfway across the globe. Jesus.
He's got AJ behind him. It's going to be difficult for AJ to overtake him. He's going to have to be very, very cautious.
Oh wow, lag McGee.
I mean, if a car lags into your car and he drives at the inside, it's contact.
He keeps Kellon lets him through. Very sportsman like behaviour. Yeah. Yeah, maybe it's on a screen as well. Deo has caught up to the back of Levi in P3. Lars has actually gotten past Levi. Oh no, Levi has pitted, I do think. Levi has pitted. If you can check that for me, that would be great, Bottler. Lars is...
Levi is lagging as well.
Maybe it's not just one person's issue, maybe it is everyone.
But the only person not to pit so far is Stim, the race leader. He's probably going for a one stop, surely.
It is inevitable, isn't it?
It was soft tires, 18 laps, and he had the safety guard to help him out.
I'm pretty sure he did pit, actually. Or, no, still zero stops. And Levi, Levi has not pit, it's just Lars, Levi has pit, sorry. Levi has pit onto the soft tires. So Lars, absolutely hunting down Stim. And Lars is pretty much your only hope of not handing Stim the win this race. But watch your penalty. Thank you very much. Well, currently, there's action further back though. AJ trying to make a move on LFC for life. The notorious that wasn't lag. What?
AJ retires. What happened?
He literally just drove himself into the wall. No lag.
Just watching back on your screen.
Wow. Alright then.
Okay,
then. Yeah. What happened there then? Oh yeah, by the way, if you could drop my stream link in the chat, that would be great. That would be a lovely jubbly. Oh, Mr. Stim is corner cutting left, right and centre as I just join onto him. He's got 6 seconds worth. You're not allowed to do that. You're not allowed to crash your car out on purpose. He might get himself into a little bit of trouble. He did say that.
AJ,
he can't be asked for this.
Yep. This race is gone.
Yep. And he has just binned himself in the wall there earlier.
Stim is really struggling on these soft tires. Not to be biased or anything, but I hope he bottles it.
No, you actually can't say that. Sorry. You can't. Yeah. You will get in trouble for that. You will get in trouble for that. Sorry. Sorry to inform you. Lars Gaming, he's taken those tyres 19 laps and there's no sign of any significant abrasion on them.
He has been sliding around this past lap though, a little bit of a lock up.
They aren't starting to blister.
Does he pull into the pit?
No, he doesn't.
He's set up another lap.
His tyres look fine to me. There's someone's in the pits, that's probably Flavio. Yes, no, it's not. Very, very spaced out field at the moment here. Under the Singapore streetlights.
Just an update on the penalties. Stim picking up another 3 second penalty, as
yep.
well as AJ, who we don't need to worry about anymore. Ash Best has a 3 second penalty, as does LFC for life.
Yeah.
So, even after the cars cross the checkered flag, this race may not be over. This could be decided on penalties.
It could. We only have 11 laps to go here in Singapore. And it is pretty much Mr. Sim's race to lose at this point. It is Mr. Sim's race to lose. That is really unfortunate, mate. How you retired, that is unfortunate.
There will be a video discussing what happened. It wasn't my fault.
Will there be a rage kitchen, by any chance?
There'll be rage, right?
But no extra kitchen?
Nope. Just rage. Pure and utter rage.
Interesting. Well, you seem very bottled up at the moment. Just let your emotions flow.
I would, but the stream will get taken down for offensive language.
Oh, Stim comes into the pits on lap 20, going on to lap 21.
He cautiously comes into the pit.
And that's going to lose him even more time to Lars, and Lars looks to jump him an absolute treat here. This is not even going to be close. Look at where Lars is already. Look at where he is. It is pretty much
he's
Lars...
already in to leave the race.
Stim onto the super soft tyres. He might have taken a gamble onto the ultra softs. They might have just gone the distance.
Nah, the super softs is the
safer option.
Default tyre.
Mandatory. Mandatory.
That's what I was looking for.
So our top four is kind of converging on each other. Oh no, Lars is miles out ahead. Never mind. Scratch that. No one's near each other anymore. As Ash, the second mana, comes into the pits. It will be interesting to see if he actually gets held up, because Stim pitted. Yep, he will. Because for some reason, Stim's pit crew is still out there, like a bunch of morons. Ash Best is going to drop to P8. Very unfortunate.
Just looking at penalties, and I think Lars Stim is one of the only cars that doesn't have a penalty.
Well, as Ash Best rejoins right behind the Zebra, sorry to cut you off there, Connor.
I was going to say, even if Stim catches him, he needs to get about 9 seconds ahead of him to actually win this race.
I just can't quite see that happen. As Ash Best does have the DRS on the Zebra 94, coming into turn number... Oh no, I've lost the track map. Bear with. Oh, he almost goes up his inside. Ash Best absolutely cuts across his inside. That was turn number 7, in case you're wondering. Turn number 7. Looks like things have actually calmed down now. I will check up on that battle later on, as Timmy has a puncture on a track that isn't that tough on the tyres. It is a very...
Oh my god, Ash Best has lost it!
Oh
what
no!
The hell? I think he clipped barrier heading into the hairpin.
Oh yeah, that happened to me in F5. Very unfortunate. Very, very unfortunate for him.
And that is his race over. He might have a puncture actually.
No, he doesn't.
I don't think I'll have any damage, so...
He is on fresh ultra softs. Yep, he is on fresh ultra softs, so I guess he can just push like hell now to try and regain those positions. He's got he's in a Haas sandwich at the moment with Soyberg in front of him and Ella behind him. And yep, other than that, nothing much going. Oh no, never mind. It's a lapped car.
That's exactly what I...
What was it, the Ferrari? No, not even Ferrari. Red Bull. Flavio, who's trying to unlap himself. Very dangerous. Oh.
I just see you pop up in the bottom. The tyres.
That's why you don't pull out vigorously from the slipstream when you have DRS open. That's a lesson for everyone. Just lost the back end. Oh, Stim Jimmicanering his manner around the Singapore street circuit. Very nice to see. Oh, it's Lars Pitts. It is Stim who's going to take a massive lead now. Oh, no. Onto the podiums, hopes and dreams crushed. Oh, Stim might have lost it. No, he didn't. But that's onto the podiums, championship hopes. scrambled up and thrown into the paper waste bin.
Oh, don't even think that I'm giving up. Don't even think that I'm giving up.
That's the attitude that we like to hear, Mr. Podium. Mr. Onto
the last race if I have to.
Not literally, because PSGL does not condone any violence of any sort. Just thought that I had to clear that up. Has Ashbest already passed Soyborg?
I'll make a rough nail. There's Gareth.
Disgusting. So Levi, 8 seconds off of Stim on very old soft tyres, and I think we already know who's... Yep. I think we already know who's won this race. Although I did say that in the early laps of this Grand Prix, and look how that turned out.
I can only hope.
This is a great race at the moment. It's provided all the drama that we wanted. A retirement from the lead. Although now it is...
It wasn't even my fault. I'm just saying that. It wasn't even my fault.
Right, you're like a broken record. But yeah, I would be furious if I was in your position. Yeah, definitely. As Ashbest is closing up to the Red Bull of the Zebra 94, who on his F6 debut is looking good for the eighth place and 2 points. No idea.
Half those points if Ashbest catch up to him. He's looking very, very quick on his soft tyres.
Oh, he's gone very wide into turn number 13, the hairpin. And I'm actually going to let you commentate this battle.
There's not really a lot happening at the moment. Ashbest sat behind the Red Bull, looking quicker, but this track, as you've seen, is difficult to overtake.
Very, very much so.
May get the DRS down the main straight, and that's probably the safer option.
Yep, you definitely don't want
to...
Oh! A little bit of contact. This is not the place that you want to have a kamikaze up the inside, although you can say that for any track, if I'm honest.
Oh, Zebra's lost it out of the final corner. Ashbest with the DRS. Is he going to go to the inside? Yes, he is. It looks like it's going to be an easy overtake. Him down to turn one, and I think Ash has done it. Yes, he has. Up in the seventh place.
Seventh, so someone must have been in the pits then. It's Tyler Neo. Tyler Neo, who has come out the pits on a new set of super softs, I think that was. Let's check further up the grid. Yep, super softs.
Must have run out of ultra soft tyres then.
Yeah, probably.
Unless he hasn't run the super soft tyres and is obligated to.
Mm. Yep.
That may be why. As we've got the Zebra not looking too quick. It looks like he's lost out to Ashbest through sector one. And despite having the DRS, it looks like he's really struggling. Let's have a look back at the race leader. Is it still Stim? Yes, it is. He is looking confident on the super soft tyres.
Unfortunate for some.
And Levi is nowhere to be seen.
Stim goes fastest is... Was that last lap? I just got the notification. So Stim absolutely tearing the field apart. 15 second gap to Levi, which was actually 7 seconds about 4 laps ago. So yeah, it just underlines the sheer dominance of Stim as Lars laps his teammate. So slightly embarrassing for Timmy. You never want to get lapped by a teammate, although that has happened to me. I got lapped by my teammate in Monaco as Tyler Neo is on the back of Ella. No get. He's going to try and make a move into the first corner. Yep, Ella moved in the braking zone. You could place that into the stewards if you want to. Not saying they have to, of course. Into turn number 5 they go. Yep. Mm-hmm. onto the DRS straight they go, and into the kink of turn number 6. He looks way too far back to make a move, but you never know with these Force Indias. Yep, he
tried. Decides against it.
Probably for the best.
Smart decision there.
Ooh, very, very, very close to the back of that Haas as they run through turn number 8 and 9. Almost a little bit of contact. I'm going to have a look further up the field again.
It seems to be the story of this race. Faster cars, stuck behind slower cars, and just can't overtake her on this track. That seems to be a theme here.
Mm-hmm.
We've seen that numerous times already.
Yep. Although, onto the podium actually was free by about 5 seconds and retired. Very unfortunate. Very, very unfortunate.
That's it. The stream's getting disliked. The stream is getting disliked.
No.
The like is gone.
Oh, I'm now down onto 2 likes. Well, Tyler Neo, still stuck behind Ella Noguet. In sector 3, where there's pretty much no overtaking opportunities, unless you are very, very brave indeed. And as they come through the final 2 corners of 22 and 23, they start lap number 26. And Tyler Neo might have Ella Noguet into the first corner. No, Ella once again closing the door, and he tries to make a move into turn number 3. He's very, very close, very opportunistic from Tyler Neo, but Ella once again closing that door through number 5 now. And I did lose the back end. I was trying oh so badly to unlap myself as safely as possible, didn't want to upset Tyler's race, but he was so slow, says Flavio, who retired after getting trying to unlap himself. Oh, it was Tyler Neo. Very, very silly move into turn number 8. He could have stuck behind him, and now he's got no front wing. Did you catch that?
I didn't. I was just taking a look at the penalties. I've just seen on the stream that crash. Last game, 3-second penalty, and LFC got another 3-second penalty, but the field is so spread out, I don't think it's going to affect anything at this stage.
And can you check if anyone's actually gone a race without getting a penalty, because that'll be very interesting to see. They might be the big winner in all of this.
I will have a look.
So yeah, Tyler,
I don't think there is a single person that doesn't have a penalty, but I will look.
So yeah, Tyler Neo trundling around in P9 without that front wing and that massive generator of downforce. That's like, that is a lot of downforce that he's missing on the front end of that Force India. But, you know, was a pretty silly move into turn number 8. He could have waited a little bit. Oh, as he goes wide at the pit entrance. And I'm pretty sure that he did speed into the pit, so I'm going to take a look at that. Oh, that is a very long scroll down to the bottom of the race director.
I don't think it's a single person without a warning, I'm going to be honest.
Any person without a penalty?
Yes, Levi. I think the only person, he's got 3 warnings, but he's the only person without a penalty as it stands.
But he's way too far behind Stim for that to have any sort of significance, as Lars Gaming is looking to promote himself up into P2 on lap 28 of 31, so we are nearing the latter step. We're already in the latter stages. We're nearing the end of this Singaporean Grand Prix. What would you rate this race? What would you rate this race out of 10 in terms of on-track battling? Because there have been quite a few battles.
I'd say 6 out of 10. There's been a few battles here and there, but it's just not the track for four-wheel racing.
Very, very true. I'd go for a 7, yeah, and just echoing the points that you made. There's Tyler Neo tagging.
My personal view, I'm going to go for a 1 out of 10.
Understandable. Tyler Neo tagging along for the battle over P2. Hopefully he doesn't get involved in any way, shape or form. We'll be right back.
last game and making a move up the inside of Levi, and there's contact. He has to cut the corner. And it looks like Tyler Neo is going to try and unlap himself. I don't think it's damage on the Ferrari. But Lars Gaming losing time. Obviously, Lars has, I think, 6 seconds more penalties. Levi doesn't, so Levi can let him through. But at this track, it's easier. It's very easy to defend. So Levi looking strong for P2 and Mr. Stim. Just too far ahead. I think he may have won this race. Hopefully I don't commentate his curse him. We wouldn't want that. The last game with the DRS. Too far behind Levi. And there's a little bit of lag there.
I come back to hear you cursing Stim.
Would I do that? Would I do that?
Probably. Oh wow.
Oh
there's...
no. A lot of lag and I thought Stim went into the wall. A lot of lap for Stim, and cars disappearing, everyone's ghosting. I don't really know what's happening.
Yeah, Stim's ghosting. What's going on here? I'm seeing the fuels to run out of fuel.
I'm not going to say I wouldn't want that. That would be unsportable.
He's still ghosting. I think he's still going around as an AI.
Wow, that's just cheating. Letting the AI finish his work as he's back now. Just showboating, looking at the race director. Most likely.
Probably, yeah. Oh, was Levi. Levi gets his penalty, so no one is going to be penaltyless this race.
The last game, I think it was 6 seconds. I want to say 6 seconds as well for penalties. So Lars is going to have to do more than just overtake the Williams car. Lars makes a move up the inside of turn one. Is he going to make move stick? Levi being very respectful and maybe too respectful as the Ferrari goes straight up the inside. Lars into second place.
They're just
Lars
two laps
quick. So Can he increase the gap to 6 seconds or 3 seconds now?
Sorry. Oh, that really hurt Lars getting stuck behind Levi whilst Levi was on half a race old softs. I want to say.
I don't think Lars will be too disappointed. I think he knows a first place isn't possible. Unless there's an incident, which we've seen before, hopefully we'll see it again.
You can't say that.
Oh dear.
Well.
I'm trying to keep a neutral standpoint as much as possible, but when you just hit the wall and lead in the race, it's very difficult.
Flavio asks what the BS crash gang is. Oh, Deo with a massively behind anyone. 20 seconds behind P3. But let's go on board with Stim as he starts the final lap of the race. Although he is red on fuel, this might not be over. And if he does in fact run out of fuel, there will be definitely stern words within the manor camp.
Plants back up LFC for life.
Hopefully he gets out of the way. Yep, very nice.
Yes, he does.
You sound very happy. Let me check the chat. You tapped the wall and your car just got destroyed.
Video on my channel.
No shout outs. So Stim is Yeah, he's already weaving. Oh, look already at that. Weaving. Disgusting.
He's already weaving.
Oh my goodness.
I did that in Italy, I have to admit.
Look at that. What, when? Oh, in Italy, alright. I thought they said that you did that initially.
That's what took me out, is karma.
So Stim, coming through the final few corners now, he is going to cruise home to his second PSGL F6 win through the final two corners, 22 and 23. Mr. Stim, 96, wins the Singaporean Grand Prix for Manna Racing. What a race. How do you think I felt in Italy?
Well, you didn't crash out.
I know, but the race was mine to lose.
Lars takes second, but will he hold on to it? I don't think he will. Who got second there?
Race director? Looks like Lars. Because Levi has 6 seconds.
Well, Levi must have cut the final.
And Lars is. Lars is 3 seconds, sorry. Not even a contest in the end. And other than that, no one is anywhere near anyone. And Timme is going to be coming across the line with a deflated rear right tyre. So, yeah. Oh yeah, and Levi just did not bottle it from third.
Only I was there.
Great stuff for him. Great stuff. I think it's time to invite our top three of Mr. Stim 96. If I could find him. Mm-hmm. Could Mr. Stim please appear on my friends list? That would be nice. I'll be there in a moment. Just trying to invite everyone I can. Lars Gaming. What's it called? What's his full PSN? No, never mind. I found Lars. What, Lars Gaming? Is it Lars Gaming 123? Right. So that's the top three invited. And let's have a look at this race director then. And wow, there's Timmy having a stop go for ignoring blue flags at the end of the race.
Not a single person, well, with the exception of the two Renault cars, not a single person.
Oh no, your teammate got disqualified.
Okay, with the exception of me, everyone had a penalty, so I'm the cleanest driver, it seems.
Oh, Stim.